Malik Sharon here. It is time to talk about picking an a cappella group name. I realize many of you already are in groups, you've already got names, but some of you are starting a new program at your school, some of you are starting a new professional group, and you need to pick a name for your group. And you don't really know how to go about it because there's not really any treaties on choosing a group name out there. Well, now there is, people. This is it. Are you ready to rock? Excuse me. Okay. Here we go. The number one consideration for your group name is that it needs to fit your image. So, if you're a boy band, then you want a boy bandy kind of name. NSYNC-y, Backstreet kind of name. I'm not saying you want to copy them. I mean, MPACT was definitely kind of going for that thing when they got started. And that makes sense, that's cool. But you can also think about words that fit within that world. So if you're gonna be like a retro doo-wop group, you probably wanna be the somethings. You know, the Persuasions and the Alley Cats are out there doing their thing, just like the Five Satins and the Orioles and the Penguins and all those kind of classic groups. If you're a classical group, you probably want to be the Something Ensemble or the Something Consort or the Camerata di Pasta Rigatoni. You know, I don't know. Something. Ooh, look, half the people clicked off this video just then. So that's number one. Number two is you want a name that's unique. Okay, fine, if you're a school group and you're an all-female a cappella group and you're like, ooh, we could be the Sirens, you can do that, but I can guarantee you there are probably 35 other a cappella groups out there called the Sirens. It's an amazing name for allegorical reasons and ambulance reasons. I mean, you do however you want to play. You can have Odysseus steer a ship into the rocks, or you can go screaming down the middle of the street at midnight in New York City. The Sirens is a great name, but so many people already have it. So can you find a name that does what you want to do and yet it's different? That's the key to a really good a cappella group name. Because number three, you want it to be available on the web, on Twitter, on Facebook. You can do a traditional copyright search, but nowadays it's a lot easier. You want to go online and you can search for, I don't know what we call yourself, the Twangy Boys. So you could type in Twangy Boys, the way you would probably spell it. Is that URL available? Is anybody the Twangy Boys on Facebook? Is anybody on Twitter? If nobody is any of those, you're probably good to go. If there is a Twangy Boys, but they're an auto shop in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, you're probably okay as well, because they're probably not going to start an a cappella group. So the Twangy Boys are doing their twangy thing, fixing cars. You're going to be the a cappella Twangy Boys. You're probably going to be totally fine. But if you find there are a couple of groups out there, or like the Twang Guys or whatever, then you start to run into some kind of questions or problems, and is it really worth it? Or you may find that spelling your name becomes a real complication, or you are able to get the name if you spell it a weird way. That gets me to number four. Don't choose a name that's difficult to spell or that is difficult to explain. So for instance, don't call your group the .coms. Because then you're like, what's your web address? Oh, we are .coms.com. So is your name spelled with a dot at the beginning, or is it D-O-T and then C-O-M-S, C-O-M-Z, and then it's a dot and then the com? Like, you'll spend 15 minutes trying to explain what your URL is. Once you're really well known, Pink can have an exclamation point for her I. Maybe some media will pick it up, but you're not gonna have that. Maybe ever, probably ever. But for the most part, you want people to hear your name, be able to find you. So you're up on stage, you're performing at a state fair. Hi, we're the Twangy Boys. Find us online and they can find you. And finally, take all this information and come up with a few different names and bounce them off people. Because there may be things that you haven't thought about. Some innuendo that your name brings up in people's minds, or it's hard to pronounce, or it conjures up other ideas and images that people that you don't want to be a part of this whole thing. It's a tough thing finding a name. Luckily, it's a lot easier picking a name now than it was 20 years ago, because you can go online and you can search and see who these people are. Before, with copyright searches and stuff, you just had to guess. Anyway, I hope this helps you guys find your good names. Please post below that some names you're considering if you want any responses from myself and anybody else. This is the name of our group. What style do you think we are? Those kind of questions, happy to answer them. Or list some of your own group's worst suggested names. I'll leave you with one that in the early days of the House Jacks, right out of college, we had a lot of really bad names. Intentionally, of course, because you're sitting around with your buddies and you're coming up with them. Harry Nipples Jr. I'm glad we didn't call the House Jacks Harry Nipples Jr., but you can call your group that. See you next time.